Buy all your Willys and Jeep restoration parts at thejeepsterman.com, because we're not just Jeepsters anymore.
With John at JeepsterMan today, we're going to talk about timing. Willys F-Head 134s. So this one, this engine came from someone else that had rebuilt it, and I tried to time this thing, could not get it to time properly. It just wouldn't run right. And when I was checking it, I was like, you know what? This thing seems like it's 180 out. And it ended up being 180 out. So something I'll show you about these distributors. This little tab on the end of the distributor, it's offset to one side. So when you're putting this distributor in and trying to line it up with the slot in the oil pump, it'll only go in one way. And this one was 180 out. Is how that worked out. So what we had to do, we had to find top dead center on number one first. So we held our finger, we took the spark plug out, held our finger over that, and then we rotated the engine over until we found the notch mark in the crank pulley, and it corresponded with compression that we had coming out of the number one. So we knew we were at top dead center when we did that. Then when we pulled the distributor out, we could see that we were 180 out. So this is number one. Our number one was all the way up here. So we knew we were 180 out. And you can get them to run by having them 180 out, but you will never get that thing to time right. We ran out of time and you couldn't get it to time right. And we knew that it wasn't right. So what we had to do next was the oil pump over here. The oil pump, we only had to remove 3 bolts. We didn't have to take the exhaust loose, nothing. So all you do is just remove those 3 bolts. And it's great if you got 2 people to do it. So you just pull that oil pump down a little bit. Don't pull it out all the way. Just lower it down just a couple inches. And at that point in time, the gear on the end of the oil pump is not connected to the gear on the cam. It'll spin freely. So then with Joan on one side, me on the other side, I took a long screwdriver, right here. And I had this distributor out. So then I was able to get in here and turn that oil pump 180 degrees. So when I turned that oil pump 180 degrees, then what we needed to do was line that up to where number one was at the 5 o'clock position. All right, so it needed to be at the 5 o'clock, and you had to, like I said, this offset only goes one way. So we had to have it lined up. So basically I would hold my distributor like so, and I would turn it to like number one, where it's supposed to be at the 5 o'clock position, and realize that I needed to turn the tab on the oil pump to this. So once we did that and I pushed the distributor in, he held the oil pump from the other side, and we got the two to clock together, the keyway locked together. Then we went ahead and put a bolt in the oil pump, got that tightened up, secured the distributor down. And wouldn't you know it, as soon as we fired this thing up, it fired right up. So we just want to talk about that problem. Whoever put this engine together, put that oil pump 180 out. You know, you expect that most of these engine rebuilders are going to do these properly, but if you run into the problem like we did and we knew it was 180 out, that's how we solved it. That's how we fixed it. It really wasn't that difficult to do. It is nice if you have 2 people to do it, but we just wanted to point this out because we've heard of this problem. Other people are having this problem. They call it static timing. We learned this off the CJ3B info site, but it's really the same for all the F-head engines on how to time those like that. So thanks for watching our video. If you got any questions, sales@thejeepsterman.com. You can email us if you need to. You can call 314-798-6462. We just thank you guys for watching.
To get a free copy of the Willys and Jeep Restoration Parts Catalog from the Jeepster Man, go to www.thejeepsterman.com and order your free copy today.
Awesome. Actually, you know what?
No high tech at all.